Hey, it's Dr. Eddie.
And Rahil.
What'd you do today, Rahil?
I went foraging for food.
Do you know what foraging is?
I think so.
Foraging is a seeking and obtaining of food resources.
Oh, okay.
Wait, where are you going? Come back here. You're doing it wrong. You need to maximize the energy per unit food while minimizing the search and handling time.
Yeah.
It's a Darth Suresh.
And I'm Ryan.
Are
you a true predator?
I'm a predator. I attack large numbers of prey with minimal energy, search, and handling time.
Do you even optimize?
Only when the first derivative is zero.
No.
What?
Optimal means maximizing the amount of energy acquired per unit time and the risk involved in finding food. As those losers said, you need to optimize your foraging. Doing so will enable you to become the most efficient hunter you can become and reproduce even more. Wouldn't you like that?
Well, you know I'll do anything for those ladies.
Okay. Well, using optimal foraging theory, E divided by S plus H, where E is the total energy consumed, S is the search time, and H is the handling time, you need to...
Wait. So I could apply this to my mass gainer, right?
Yeah.
Think about it. I get 2,000 calories per serving, and I divide that by the time it takes me to find the bottle and mix the powder, right?
I guess that works, yeah.
And, you know, I want to be maximized, so I want to spend the least amount of time trying to find the ingredients. So I'll keep that in mind next time.
Well, as you can see, another aspect of optimal foraging is population density. For example, with a belting ground squirrel, a small population doesn't have to travel as far to obtain food. However, as population size increases, it needs to travel even further and further to obtain food.
Word. So, it's kind of like when my species of Homo sapiens go to Taco Bell. And, you know, they run out of food, so we have to go find another Taco Bell that's even farther away.
I guess, yeah, sure.
So when my multiple aunts, cousins, and sisters procreate through the founder effect, we'll have to travel even farther for food?
Mm-hmm. Hey, you're on.
What?
Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for a message from our sponsors. Are you tired of spending so much energy and traveling so far looking for food? Are you tired of spending so much time trying to crack these nuts?
Hell nah, bro.
Are you tired of not having enough energy to do the asexual and give the ladies what they came for? We've got just the thing for you. Rahil Patel, at a whopping 5'8", 147-pound, and a vertical that rivals that of Neil Gold himself.
I'll give you the most bang for your buck.
This limited liability company takes no responsibility for any damages and or fatalities caused by the use of Rahil Patel. Side effects include but are not limited to AIDS, love of broccoli, mind-blowing pleasure, male prostitution, increased resistance to Ebola, STDs, party rocking, and death.